We're now officially halfway through 2024, and I know a lot of us mobile gamers have yet to find a mobile MMO that could get us addicted. There have been a lot of MMOs for Android and iOS that have come out lately, but there's no way to find out if they will be to your liking. I guess the only way to find out is to check them out. So today, here are 10 new MMORPGs for Android and iOS as of the second quarter of 2024. Starting off in number 10, we have Rebirth Origin of Universe. Rebirth Origin of Universe is a magical MMORPG offering intricate graphics reminiscent of World of Warcraft. Players can explore the game's rich world through online or team modes, embarking on adventure together. There are currently only 3 classes to choose from, but they're not gender locked. You have Dragon Spear, Star Caller, and Soul Hunter. There aren't many players in game though, and I bet only a few know about the game's existence, which makes it difficult to find teams for dungeon raids. It also still has many bugs since it's still in early access, so you might want to wait a little bit before trying out this game. Oh, and I'd like to introduce you to our sponsor for this video, Awesome Remote. With Awesome Remote, you can access your work laptop or gaming computer from your phone, tablet, or PC. It's the fastest, most reliable, and free remote access tool that lets users remotely access, control, and troubleshoot their computers from a phone, tablet, or PC. It's available on Windows, macOS, Android, and iOS. The best part about Awesome Remote is that it's free, and the controls are customizable. I mean, you can easily connect your PC via desktop control. Once connected, you can just tap on the gaming keyboard on the right side of the screen, choose your preferred presets, and tap use. Customize the buttons according to your game's control settings, and you can now play your PC games as if they are mobile games. It also supports gaming up to 144 FPS for a much smoother experience. You can also control your desktop via your phone through Awesome Remote or do some screen mirroring. There's a free version, but if you want to take advantage of the feature included in their paid plan, such as the virtual keyboard and faster remote access connection, you can get up to 40% off by using the link I have in the description. Oh, and they also have a device called Smart Plug, which you can use to wake or shut down your computer with just one tap. If you're interested in trying out Awesome Remote, links are just down below. Moving on to number 9, we have Draconia Saga. Alright, so this game is actually the mobile version of Dragon Slayer Hunter Hero, a game from, I think, about a decade ago. They seem to have remade the game and added crossplay compatibility between mobile and PC. I don't know if they use the same assets, but the Draconia Saga looks a little bit more up-to-date in terms of visuals. Draconia Saga is a fantasy adventure game where humans and pets coexist harmoniously. Players capture various pets, each with unique evolutionary paths, to form teams and explore vast continent alongside fellow dragon hunters. You're gonna be able to select non-gender locked classes ranging from warrior, archer, dancer, and lancer with a variety of customization options. Pets also assist you in combat and contribute to diverse tactical combinations. Players can also engage in community activities, form guilds, and build homes. Next up at number 8, we have Order Daybreak. Order Daybreak is a game that is set in a post-apocalyptic world infused with sci-fi and anime elements. Players become ageless warriors, navigating a dynamic isometric perspective to engage in strategic combat and form alliances with diverse allies to combat spreading corruption. There are 4 gender-locked classes to choose between. There's Swiftblade, Slayer, Gunslinger, and Seer. The game features real-time combat requiring precise skill execution, multiple classes for unique progression paths, and customizable gear for both functionality and style. It also features cross-play server play, where players can forge and break alliances globally, creating a constantly evolving narrative as they strive to shape the future of a world on the brink of collapse. And number 7, we have Ancient World. Ancient World is a 3D MMORPG that immerses players in a mystical land inspired by a beloved fantasy novel enriched with cutting-edge blockchain technology. Set 1,000 years after the original saga, players consume the roles of valiant warriors, navigating beautifully crafted landscapes, uncovering ancient lore, and battling monstrous invasions. There are 4 classes to select between: Berserker, Spirit Fox, Spear Shadow, and Sword Ring. Only the Spear Shadow and Sword Ring have 2 gender options though, and the rest are gender locked. The game also features dynamic combat, diverse gameplay, and deep storylines, allowing players to master various combat styles, enhance gear, and customize characters. Unique systems like summoning divine servants, riding majestic mounts, and wielding powerful weapon artifacts also offer decent experiences. In addition, players can earn Taiko coins and mint NFTs, linking in-game achievements to real-world economic benefits, making every quest and battle a chance to gain valuable treasures and make money online. Sitting at number 6, we have Wandering Swordius. Wandering Swordius is an open-world wuxia MMORPG inspired by ancient martial arts and Jin Yong's Legendary Swordsman novel, where players choose characters and embark on a thrilling adventure in a vibrantly rendered world. You will engage in PvE and PvP battles, mastering diverse martial art styles and developing skills. The game offers a rich character development system, allowing players to enhance abilities and acquire new gear. The game also features decent customization options for unique character looks. Gameplay-wise though, there doesn't seem to be anything special about this MMO. I mean, it's quite comparable to those wuxia games you can already find on Play Store. But if you're into sword martial arts or wuxia MMOs and are looking for one, there you go. Moving on to number 5, we have Mujiang M. Mujiang M is an MMORPG that breaks the traditional class restrictions, allowing players to freely develop their characters without class limitations. Basically, just like Albion, players can learn and practice various martial arts and weapons, such as katanas, spears, swords, fists, bows, and darts, each offering unique skills and abilities. Set in ancient China, the game features panoramic views of historical landmarks and cities, creating an atmosphere with vibrant, traditional Chinese animation-inspired designs. The combat system is quite decent, emphasizing PvP battles for intense, exciting encounters. In addition, the game includes a rich life system, allowing players to gather, hunt, and mine to create unique items, offering an immersive experience beyond combat. Next up at number 4, we have Soul of Ring Revive. Soul of Ring Revive is an MMORPG set in a world plagued by man-eating demons. In this dark era, witches and their elf offspring sacrifice their magic and lives to create the ultimate magic ring to resist the demons. Players wielding the magic ring must battle these demonic foes. You have 4 gender-locked classes to choose between: Wanderer, Archer, Stargazer, and Fencer. The game features a unique ring system offering powerful abilities and a connected economy for free trading, but there aren't much customization options, and the game also has VIP system, which a lot of us gamers don't like. Nevertheless, this is one of the most recent MMOs you can try if you are looking for one. Sitting at number 3, we have Flame of Valhalla. Flame of Valhalla is an MMORPG that puts players into the enchanting open-world realm of Asgard, where the world tree has been shattered by a cataclysmic event, scattering fragments imbued with sacred energy across the cosmos. In the game, players embark on an epic Nordic fantasy adventure, exploring a vast open world teeming with realistic weather dynamics and nice-looking landscapes. Gameplay-wise, the game has autoplay feature and quite pay-to-win, but that's to be expected from mobile MMORPGs, so there's kinda no surprise there. But I'm quite impressed by the game's graphics. You will have 5 gender-locked classes to choose between: Knight, Mage, Archer, Warrior, and Astrologer. The game is set in an isometric open world where there are lots of places to explore and level up in. Down to number 2, we have Cursed Sword Demon Whispers. Cursed Sword Demon Whispers is a dark fantasy MMORPG featuring boss battles, gorgeous combat, and freeform customization. Players face formidable enemies in strategic, team-based encounters, earning high-tier gear with each victory. You're gonna have 4 gender-locked classes to select between: Pikeman, Swordsman, Spellcaster, and Viper. The game also offers kind of a freedom in character customization, allowing players to choose unique skills and appearances with a diverse array of fashionable outfits. Finally, at number 1, we have AO3 Dancestar. AO3 Dancestar is a vibrant 3D music and dance social MMO set in an enchanting starry town, where players can showcase their dancing talents and experience the allure of music and dance. The game offers a variety of play modes with trendy dance steps and rich selection of songs, allowing players to shine as top dancers at music parties. With detailed facial customization and rich makeup system, players can also create unique looks and design their own fashionable clothing. The game also features social elements, enabling players to join dance guilds, compete in challenges, and engage in leisurely activities like fishing and karaoke with friends. Now, in my opinion, this is a very relaxing social MMO, yet hardcore at the same time, but also allows you to try something that's different from the usual MMO mechanics. Alright gamers, that'll be all for this video. I know most of the recent MMOs are unable to meet our standards, and it's quite sad that mobile MMOs are not improving at all. And if anything, they seem to be regressing instead. But I guess it is what it is. Oh, and I forgot that Tarislan is also coming out very soon, so you also might want to look forward to that. Thank you very much for watching the video, my fellow mobile gamers. Subscribe to the channel. There's a lot of mobile games to be discovered here. Stay safe, everyone, and happy gaming.